Let us bow our heads and pray. Brothers and sisters of the congregation, today I came to service for the first time in 5 weeks. Expected some change up in here, but I guess after the new year, some things still remain the same. Pastor said he was going to start being timely and get us out of service on time, and he lied once again. I had the whole day blocked out, and I thought I would have enough time to pick up some wings, some chicken, maybe a few brewskis, and some sides. But I guess not, since Pastor took all that time away, and he said he was going to be 15 minutes. And then he said he needed an additional 35 minutes, so we gave him 30 more minutes, because he wasn't going to let the devil put a time limit on what he had to say. You're right. But then the sermon ended up being 2 whole hours long. Now, who on earth preaches for that long? Now, my problem is that I had a Super Bowl party planned, and while I was trying to text my friends, when the pastor, that he would only be 15 minutes, then he pointed out that we should not be using the devil's devices during the service, I put my phone away. Then he said he needed another 30 minutes. I was going to be kindly enough to just use my church ring and excuse myself up out of here, but then he started talking about those of you who come up in the service don't give your whole life, give your whole self. Stop thinking about what you're going to do after service and think about what you can do during the service. Man, he messed up my whole thought with that. Then when I finally turned my phone back on, that's when I noticed the 15-minute sermon had turned into 32 hours. So in conclusion, I just want to say, Pastor, I'm asking you to come up here after this prayer and ask for your forgiveness for all your lies and all that mind reading you was doing. And please take note, because this prayer was only a few minutes, because I know you have an anniversary dinner because your mother is turning 70 years old. But I'm going to make sure, just like you did with me, that you were there on time and not 2 hours late. So now, since you used to be 2 hours late anyway, let's have everybody in the congregation come up here and give a special prayer on behalf of the pastor. All 500 of y'all can line up, because I know you have something to say. How about we start off with the men who missed the Super Bowl like I did first?